Good afternoon or good evening, YouTube. What's going on? It's Mesa back at it with some Destiny 2. All right, folks, we got a number of things to cover in this video. If I sound a little weird, I'm recording from my hotel room in Bellevue, Washington. I'm here for the Destiny Community Summit, and we're going to talk about a few things in this video as one of the embargoes has lifted. And also, guys, sorry, I don't have my pop screen with me, so just bear with my voice during this video. So the first thing that I want to discuss with you guys is my overall impressions of this summit. If you didn't know what the summit is, it's called the Destiny Community Summit, where Bungie and Activision brought out a host of people to not only have hands-on time with some content, but really to discuss things with the developers. And they brought everyone out here, from Twitch streamers, to content creators, to podcasters, to just people that are in the community. And the goal was to show us some things, which, look, guys, I'm gonna be very, very vague in this video, okay? I'm under strict NDA. I saw and experienced and played a lot of things that I can't really talk about, but safe to say, I am extremely excited about it. But the goal really was to help make Destiny a better game. So they brought us all in, and we had some as well. Back in my old medical device sales days, we had a lot of what's called courageous conversations. And what I mean by courageous conversations from the business world is, well, asking those uncomfortable questions, talking about things we don't like, things we'd like to see improved, things we want back, things we want taken out of the game, and so forth. Now, for the peanut gallery folks, I know there's a number of you guys out there saying, this is just a PR stunt. They're bringing out a bunch of yes men to tell them how great their game is. Look, if you've been following this Destiny Community Summit, you know they brought out a lot of people who totally have tapped out on Destiny 2, whether it's from content creation, whether it's from streaming, or just straight up playing the game. They brought people from every walks of life who, like me, I still play the game. I have over 600 hours played. But more importantly, you know, look, they got to appease everybody. They have to appease the PvP folks. They have to appease us PvEers. There's a lot of work to be done on this game. And I am a broken record, and I don't care. I'm saying it again. Look, people forget how much work Destiny 1 needed in year 1. And then when The Taken King came out, it changed the way we played the game, and it became the masterpiece it was for the rest of its life cycle, for the most part. Now, in terms of questions that we had for Bungie, I mean, they were all over the place, guys. And sadly, I can't talk about the answers. But rest assured, okay, their goal is to return this to the hobby that Destiny 1 was. They want to give you a reason, give us a reason, to log in every day and either feel like you've accomplished something or you're working towards a goal. Now, in the current roadmap, we have weapon randomization and we also have weapon slot changes. And we probably spent about 2 hours grilling the Bungie devs in one particular breakout on how this is all going to play out. Sadly, I can't give you any details or discuss what they're working on. However, I can say that I was very, very happy with what they proposed and what they're working on. I think we're all going to be happy in the end when it comes to those particular topics. Look, guys, I know I'm being very vague here because, look, strict NDA and those things are no freaking joke. All I know is that I think you guys are going to be excited when they start rolling stuff out with regards to weapon randomization and also weapon slot changes. Now, there was a ton of questions regarding endgame, okay? Especially from me. Tons of things. What's going to keep us logging in every day? What's going to keep us logging in every week and so forth? What's the investment for me, okay? How can I leave a play session and feel like I've accomplished something? All of those were discussed. And of course, solutions were proposed not only by us, but they showed us what they're working on to address all of these concerns that we have. And safe to say, guys, I left today's session really excited about the future. And you can call me a shill all you want, but I think lately we've weeded out all the trolls in my comment section. I think the people who stuck around with my channel still have high hopes for this game, still enjoy the game, and at the end of the day, want the game to be better. Let's just say, from my perspective, I left today's breakouts, discussions, one-on-one discussions with developers. I actually had lunch with Eric McGurk, Eric Osborne, right when I got to Seattle. I am very excited, and it goes back to, again, what I've said in the past. I have no worries about this game. None, okay? I look at the track record, or before I went to this meeting, I was going off the track record of what they did with Destiny 1, right? Destiny 1, I hate using this term, but it's true. Destiny 1 in year one was kind of a train wreck and became amazing over time. They're doing the exact same thing to Destiny 2. Guarantee it, mark my words. Now, this last part of the video is kind of going to kill me a little bit because I got to play a game mode that was absolutely amazing, and I can't share the details with you just yet. You're going to have to wait on that. However, I can give you my overall impressions and general thoughts of this game mode. The first thing I will say is, from a game mode perspective, you've never experienced, when you get to play this, you've never experienced a game mode like this in any Destiny franchise, and probably not in other franchises. I know right away everyone's probably speculating, Battle Royale, Fortnite, because I think Black Ops 4 is going Battle Royale. No, it's not that. But I can say that it was definitely unique, and I did not want to stop playing. I was actually annoyed that I had to get out of the station because I was having a really good time. It was fun, it was challenging, and it made me want to keep playing, thus grinding. And if you guys know me, if you know my channel for a long time, I have the attention span of an angry mosquito, okay? I get bored very quickly, okay? This thing kept me interested, kept me engaged, and was a lot of fun. And I will end it with saying that I did get a few similar experiences, player experiences, from the year of 2015. What I mean by that is that it wasn't things from 2015, it wasn't any type of game mode from 2015, but I got a similar player experience. Read into that all you want. I'll give you an example. When I say player experience, to me, the raid lair right now, Argos, is a similar player experience to Axis Challenge Mode. There's lots of call-outs, there's lots of movement, it's just chaos going on. So this game mode had some elements of some experiences that I had in Destiny 1 in 2015. I'll just leave it at that. Speculate in the comment section. So that's going to do it for the video, guys. Look, I'd like to give you more details, but I can't. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and turn on those notifications. There will be other embargoes, maybe one, maybe two, maybe three, maybe 10. I can't say a word. I gotta let you speculate. However, I will have some more content coming shortly. And we know next week on the 24th, we will have the reveal of Warmind, the next DLC, which drops on May 8th. Big thank you to Activision for flying me out to Bungie Studios. And a big thank you to the Bungie devs for being so effing candid. Those guys are just normal dudes like us, okay? They just happen to get to make a great game for a living, which I wish I could do. But they're just normal dudes, man. Like, they want to make a game that they would enjoy, that we would enjoy. Look, they took some risks. They made changes when they released Destiny 2. I wouldn't say that they're going to go back and make everything like Destiny 1 because I think that would defeat the purpose. But those are the types of conversations we were having today, which is to improve Destiny 2 but still make it unique, okay? I know everyone wants to go back and just change everything, send it to Destiny 1. That's not the point. This is a new game. This is a continuation of the franchise, and it needs to be different but also have that fun factor, man. Make it that experience where it's a hobby. I feel the need to log in. I need to log in every day. I need to get something accomplished. I want to have fun. And I am in full babble mode, if you haven't realized, because I haven't gotten any sleep and I need to go to bed. So first thing I need you to do is leave me a hashtag made it to the end, if you did make it to the end. And do me a favor, drop a like in this video, only if you see fit. Follow me on the Twitter at MesaSean. Check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube, and that's it. I'm out of here like Vladimir, and wow, I actually just did a non-scripted video that timed it just before the end of this Crucible match. Now let's see, how did I do this game? 28? Not bad. I bet a lot of those were assists. Bye, guys!